Queensland is on cyclone watch with fears a tropical low could intensify overnight. But it's not the only threat. A second monsoonal low is brewing in the Gulf, and there's warnings it too could become a cyclone by next week. Our reporter Lisa Rolls joins us now. And Lisa, it looks like we could get our first cyclone of the season on Christmas Day.
Yes, Max, it's even surprised forecasters. The low pressure system, which is bringing all the rain, deepened overnight, and the Weather Bureau now says there is a very real chance it could further intensify into a low grade cyclone. If it happens, it'll be called Cyclone Tasha, and it's likely it will cross the North Queensland coast near Cairns tomorrow morning. Around the same time, children are opening up all those presents. Now, the Weather Bureau has also just issued a severe weather warning for damaging wind gusts, heavy rain, and further flooding between south of Mackay and Cairns. The situation will be monitored and updated every 6 hours. But authorities are very worried about the torrential rain and a warning of severe flooding in major regional centres. Floodwaters are already testing the patience of people in North Queensland.
9:30 last night, it was open. So we're only doing what we're told.
So no, I'm not passing back this
way. Motorists, many of whom have been stuck since yesterday on the flooded Bruce Highway north of Townsville, clashed with police and traffic controllers, desperate to get through.
I've been here since 2 o'clock yesterday. I don't know. I'm just getting a little fed up now.
Well, I've got 2 kids. Santa's got to come, doesn't he?
It didn't help when one lane was opened. Only trucks and four-wheel drives were allowed through. Many families still stuck there tonight with more rain coming.
This is a time to be extremely cautious about travelling on any of our roads.
Rivers and creeks across central and north Queensland are continuing to rise. Chinchilla residents among those at risk of being cut off. The Premier given an emergency briefing this morning.
This is a time to be extremely cautious about travelling on any of our roads.
But there is so much more rain to come. Parts of north Queensland could cop up to 600 millimetres over the Christmas weekend.
And on a worst case scenario, we could see major flooding events in more than one centre with large population. I stress that is a worst case scenario, but we want to be prepared for the worst and hope for the best.
Extra emergency crews and equipment are on standby, and the Tropical Cyclone Warning Centre has been activated. Making matters worse, a second low pressure system is now brewing in the Gulf.
There's some chance that it could develop into a tropical cyclone.
Whether it does or doesn't become a cyclone, it doesn't change the fact we're in for a wet week. It's expected the torrential rain from up north will hit southeast Queensland by New Year's Eve, and then it will be our turn to worry about major flooding. For the first time, Queensland has appointed one man to be in charge of the disaster response.
I would ask everyone to consider personal safety above everything else over this next period.
And while plenty of people have changed their Christmas plans, kids shouldn't worry about Santa tonight.
Oh, all in all, we're in for a very wet Christmas Eve, but I'm confident that Santa will still find his way to all the houses in Queensland.
Lisa Rolls, 10 News.
And Dick Whittaker joins us now from the Weather Channel. Dick, how has the last 24 hours looked to you?
Well, the last 24 hours, we've still seen some pretty big totals, particularly over the tropical northern parts of Queensland. And rain has also extended. We've had thunderstorms over the central western parts as well. So we've got plenty of rain coming down in various parts of the state.
Now, we've just heard another low pressure system could form in the Gulf. Could this be a double whammy for our state?
Well, at this stage, it's a bit hard to see what effect the two low-pressure cells will have individually, but we know without doubt it's going to produce a lot of heavy rain. We've got a very moist feed-in of tropical air coming down from the north, and that's going to stream across Queensland over the next 2 to 3 days and interact with what we call an upper-level trough. And all those two systems together are going to produce a lot of rain, particularly along the Queensland coast, but also eastern inland areas. And we'd have to say that widespread flooding is very possible over the next 5 days.
Okay, we'll watch with interest. Our thanks to Dick Whittaker joining us there from the Weather Channel.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Well, riverside areas of Brisbane have been hit with king tides for a fourth day in a row. The flooding today was not as severe. Homes and businesses were spared thanks to some preemptive sandbagging, but more than a dozen roads were cut in low-lying suburbs. All ferry services remained in operation despite water lapping at the terminals.
Oh, it's good to get the rain, I suppose, but we've had enough of it, but now, for a while.
With only one gate remaining open at Wivenhoe, the anticipated surge into the Brisbane River was reduced since earlier this month. The equivalent of 400 days' worth of water usage has been released from the dam.
Meanwhile, Sunshine Coast residents are bracing for more destructive landslides. This condemned house in Budrum moved further down the hill today after the owners were forced to evacuate this week. Heavy rain is undermining the foundation and causing it to collapse. In the hinterlands, slides continue to cause lengthy delays. The Obi-Obi Road near Mapleton has been closed since April. More saturated ground is expected to give way, and emergency services are asking travellers to take care in the dangerous conditions.